Inflammation can be useful or harmful, depending on the condition. On the one hand, it's your body's biological way of defending itself when you're injured or ill. It can support your body, protect itself from infection, and facilitate healing. On the other hand, chronic inflammation is connected to a raised risk of conditions like diabetes, heart disease, and obesity. Interestingly, the foods you eat can greatly impact inflammation in your body. Here are the top 10 foods that can cause inflammation in the body. Before we continue with the list, make sure to subscribe to Healthy Lab and turn on the notification bell to help us grow. Every subscriber is much appreciated. So, let's start. 10. Sugar. Sugar, or sucrose, is consisted of 50% glucose and 50% fructose. One of the harmful causes of added sugars is that they can improve inflammation, which can lead to infection and many diseases. In one study in 2018, mice fed high sucrose diets generated breast cancer that spread to the other parts of their bodies like the lungs, partially due to the inflammatory reaction to sugar. In another study, the anti-inflammatory impacts of omega-3 fatty acids were damaged in mice fed a high sugar diet. In a randomized clinical test in which people consumed regular soda, milk, diet soda, or water, only those in the common soda group had improved uric acid levels, which causes inflammation and insulin resistance in most people. Sugar can also be detrimental because it delivers extra amounts of fructose. While the small doses of fructose in fruits and veggies are acceptable, ingesting large amounts of added sugars is harmful. Consuming a lot of fructose has been connected to obesity, diabetes, insulin resistance, fatty liver condition, cancer, and chronic kidney disorder. Also, researchers have reported that fructose drives inflammation within the endothelial cells that line your blood vessels, a risk factor for a heart disorder. High fructose intake has also improved several inflammatory markers in mice and humans. Foods high in added sugar contain candy, chocolate, soft drinks, cookies, cakes, sweet pastries, donuts, and certain cereals also contain sugar. 9. Artificial trans fats. Synthetic trans fats are probably the most harmful fats you can consume. They're made by adding hydrogen to liquid unsaturated fats to give them the strength of more solid fat. On component labels, trans fats are usually itemized as partly hydrogenated oils. Most margarine has trans fats, usually added to processed foods to prolong shelf life. Unlike the naturally occurring trans fats in dairy and meat, synthetic trans fats have been demonstrated to cause inflammation and enhance disease risk. In addition to reducing HDL cholesterol, trans fats may damage the process of the endothelial cells lining your arteries, which is a significant risk factor for heart problems. Ingesting artificial trans fats is connected to high inflammatory markers, such as C-reactive protein. Actually, in one study, CRP levels were about 80% higher among women with the highest trans fat intake. In a randomized controlled test including older women with extra weight, hydrogenated soybean oil improved inflammation more than palm and sunflower oils. Investigations in healthy men and men with high cholesterol levels have shown similar boosts in inflammatory markers in response to trans fats. Some examples of foods high in trans fats are French fries, chips, and microwave popcorn. 8. Vegetable and seed oils. During the 20th century, the eating of vegetable oils grew by 140% in America. Some scientists think certain vegetable oils, like soybean oil, stimulate inflammation due to their very high omega-6 fatty acid component. Although some dietary omega-6 fats are essential, the standard Western diet delivers far more than people require. In fact, health experts suggest eating more omega-3 rich foods like fatty fish to enhance your omega-6 to omega-3 ratio and reap the anti-inflammatory advantages of omega-3s. In one examination, rats fed a diet with an omega-6 to omega-3 ratio of 20:1 had much more elevated levels of inflammatory features than those fed diets with ratios of 1:1 or 5:1. Nevertheless, proof that a high intake of omega-6 fatty acids improves inflammation in humans is presently restricted. Collected studies indicate that linoleic acid, the most typical dietary omega-6 acid, does not influence inflammatory markers. Vegetable and seed oils are utilized as cooking oils and are significant ingredients in many processed foods. 7. Refined carbohydrates. Carbs have gained a bad rap, but the truth is that not all carbohydrates are bad. However, consuming refined carbs may cause inflammation. Refined carbohydrates have lost their fiber due to the refining process. Fiber encourages fullness, enhances blood sugar management, and provides healthy bacteria in your gut. Experimenters indicate that the refined carbs in the modern diet may promote the growth of inflammatory gut bacteria that can raise your risk of obesity and inflammatory bowel disorder. Refined carbs include a higher glycemic index than unprocessed ones. High GI foods increase blood sugar more rapidly than low GI foods. In another study, young, healthful males who ate 50 grams of refined carbs from white bread shared higher blood sugar levels and gains in levels of a certain inflammatory marker. Refined carbohydrates are in bread, sugary soft drinks, pasta, some cereals, and all processed foods have extra sugar or white flour. 6. Drinking alcohol. Medium alcohol drinking has been indicated to deliver some health advantages. However, higher doses can lead to extreme situations. In one study, levels of the inflammatory marker CRP were raised in people who drank alcohol. The more alcohol they drank, the more their CRP levels raised. People who drink heavily may create issues with bacterial toxins moving out of the colon and into their bodies. This disease is often called a leaky gut. It can cause overall inflammation that leads to organ damage. To bypass alcohol-related health issues, intake should be restricted to 2 standard drinks per day for males and 1 for females. 5. Processed meat. Eating processed meat boosts the risk of heart problems, diabetes, and gut and colon cancer. Standard processed meat includes sausage, bacon, ham, smoked meat, and beef jerky. Processed meat includes more advanced glycation end products, called ages, than most other types of meats. Ages are created by cooking meats and some other foods at high temperatures. They are famous for causing inflammation. Of all the illnesses connected to processed meat consumption, its relationship with colon cancer is the strongest. Although many elements contribute to colon cancer, one agent is supposed to be colon cells' inflammatory reaction to processed meat. 4. Monosodium glutamate. In a study, researchers injected this additive into laboratory mice and observed that after the injection, they developed various inflammatory diseases such as type 2 diabetes, liver diseases, and obesity. Although this compound is recognized as safe by the FDA, according to the newest studies, it was discovered that people who intake the most of this substance, about 5 grams, compared to those who receive the least amount of this substance were about 33% more overweight and obese. 3. Gluten. Many prefer not to consume foods that include gluten. Also, individuals with diseases like celiac disorder cannot tolerate gluten due to its impacts on the intestine. There is an inflammatory response that can influence the organs and tissues. Bread, couscous, and some other foods made with wheat, barley, and rye are the culprits. Prevent inflammation by buying gluten-free foods. When reading the labels, however, guarantee that the gluten-free product does not have excessive added components like potato starch or tons of sugar. 2. Aspartame. Aspartame is an unnatural sugar and contains no nutritional value. It was mainly utilized by people with diabetes years ago but is now used as a substitute for sugar. People decide to purchase diet sodas and other sugar-free food things as a weight management aid. Not only does aspartame derive inflammation, but it also could lead to you making more unhealthy options. Aspartame and other sweeteners like it may make you crave more sweet food and turn your back on veggies and other less intensely sweet foods. 1. Soda. The outcome of a study in Switzerland indicated that the level of CRP in young males who consumed 2 cans of soda daily raised by 109% during 3 weeks. An increase in CRP in the body can enhance the risk of cardiovascular problems and stroke in people. You can mix some citrus juice with your carbonated water to bring the taste of carbonated water somehow closer to soda. Inflammation can happen in reaction to many stimuli, some of which are difficult to control, including pollution, harm, or illness. However, you have much more management over elements like your diet.